In this learning module, we will take a high-level look at Spotfire text areas. Text areas can be configured as an important component of the interactive analysis environment because, in addition to providing an arena for text and images, text areas can also provide interactive elements, which include filters, dynamic items, property controls, action controls, and JavaScript. When combined with instructional text, these elements become powerful tools toward the design of routine analysis workflows. The text area toolbar represents these capabilities as icons, and those icons, which are intended for formatting text, including images, configuring web links, and adjusting the background of the text area, are all reasonably self-explanatory. However, the remaining items on this list may require a bit more explanation in order for you to appreciate their value. You may include filters in text areas rather than the filters panel. Presenting filters in text areas may provide several advantages. First, filters in text areas can be positioned pretty much anywhere on the page. And because they are presented in a text area, you can position them right next to instructional text or images and make them an integral part of the workflow directions. In addition, inserting filters into text areas affords the capability to display filters from different filtering schemes on the same page at the same time, something which cannot be done within the filters panel. Dynamic items which can be inserted into text areas are the same elements you will find in a graphical table visualization: spark lines, calculated values, icons, and bullet graphs. These will adjust dynamically according to the indicated filtering scheme, and, like filters, their inclusion within text areas represents an opportunity to incorporate these elements right along with the instructional text, which places that element into context, rather than being isolated in a graphical table visualization. Let's take a look at a demonstration where both filters and dynamic items have been configured within text areas. Use Open File and navigate to the example with Text Area Overview in the title. Click Open and agree to the terms and conditions of use. This example uses expense report information as its underlying data table. On the next page, two text areas have been configured. The first text area includes a filter and a calculated value, as we interact with the filter to isolate only the report status values in which we are most interested. This bar chart and the calculated value in the text area respond to the changes in that filtering scheme. The filter displayed in this text area represents a separate filtering scheme, which has been configured to limit data in this bar chart. Note that three icons have also been configured within this text area, and the icons change color according to the average expense amount resulting from the divisions which have been filtered to. The color changes configured for these circular icons are intended to mimic a stoplight, depending upon whether the average expense amount is low, medium, or high. Before we leave this page, take note that these truly are filters, just as they would appear in the filters panel. They have simply been positioned differently on the page. They should not be confused with property controls. Property controls allow you to collect, change, or display values which are stored as properties within the analysis document, separate from the data in underlying data tables. These values may be configured to perform a variety of tasks, including changing visualization properties, which either make it easier for you to perform routine analysis chores or add capabilities which would not otherwise be available for users of other Spotfire client types. Although we don't have time to view an example of each of these capabilities within the scope of this learning module, let's return to our demonstration and look at a few select examples. On the tab titled Property Controls, two text areas have been configured. This text area presents a property control which allows you to select the aggregation you wish to apply to bar chart A. The control type is a drop-down list and presents only a select set of aggregation options from which to choose. This text area allows you to select from a select list of columns to display along the category axis of this bar chart, which has been configured to count the number of expense reports assigned to each categorical value. While this is a list box property control type, this property control is a slider. Changing the property value using the slider control will change the position of the reference line in bar chart B. Why would you want to configure these property controls when you have similar control options already presented elsewhere? Well, the first reason you might take the time to configure these controls is that select aggregations or columns are now provided within those controls, which might be easier than using the standard property selectors, especially if your data table has thousands of columns. And changing the value for a fixed reference line would otherwise involve opening the properties dialog each time you wanted to reposition the line. A second reason you might take the time to configure these controls is because you wish to provide users of other Spotfire clients the ability to change an aggregation, column, or line position on a visualization when these controls are not otherwise available within those client types. One final item of note is the fourth property control type, which is presented on this page. You may have noticed that the values displayed in bold within this paragraph change depending upon the property values selected in these two property controls. These are known as label property control types, and they can be quite useful when you wish to display but not select a property value within a text area. In addition to property controls, a user may encounter action controls configured within a text area. Action controls are buttons, links, or images which are configured to perform a variety of actions. Some of these configurations are straightforward menu-driven options where absolutely no programming skills are required. Others do require some code writing, or at least some code editing skills. However, the payoff is the capability to implement the vast array of automation APIs provided by Spotfire as custom controls within text areas. In either case, the goal, again, is to make it easier for you and those with whom you share your analysis to perform routine analysis chores or to add capabilities which would not otherwise be available to users of other Spotfire client types. Finally, though configuring a button to execute a data function on a statistical engine is really simple, the process of configuring a data function is beyond the scope of this learning module. Again, let's return to the demonstration example where we can examine a couple of action control buttons, links, or images which have been configured within text areas. On the tab titled Action Controls, two text areas are presented. If we mark some data of interest in the cross-table visualization in an effort to populate the details on demand panel, the two buttons configured within this text area make it easy to work with that marked data to invert the marking, such that the marked rows are unmarked and unmarked rows are marked, or to remove the marking entirely using the Unmark button so that we can start again. While both of these operations are available via a right mouse click submenu, having them presented as buttons makes them easier to work with in a situation where we plan to repeatedly drill down into the data displayed in this crosstable as part of our routine analysis task. In this text area, links have been configured to activate bookmarks. Each of these bookmarks were captured with a different filter organization configured, such that we can now select which set of filters we want to have displayed in the filters panel. While this could also be accomplished using the actual bookmarks, presenting them in a text area makes switching between filter sets much easier. Finally, two images are included in this text area, which have been configured to facilitate navigation. Let's click the next arrow and proceed to the next page of this analysis. While the standard what you see is what you get text area in Spotfire provides quite a few text formatting options which help you to make the content readable, other configuration options are available by editing the HTML which results from the standard editor. In addition, you may include JavaScript in order to improve the appearance and include interactive functionality within your Spotfire text area content. Let's return to the demonstration one more time in order to examine an example where HTML editing and the inclusion of JavaScript has enhanced the capabilities presented within a text area. While this text area represents the starting point for building content in a text area by using the standard text area editor, on the tab titled HTML and JavaScript, the same text area presented on the previous page has been edited using the HTML editor, which can be launched using this icon on the title bar of the text area. You can see the edited HTML related in this dialog. JavaScript was also included in order to add interactive functionality within the text area, and double-clicking on this icon will expose the Insert JavaScript dialog. we can select the Expand Collapse script and click the Edit button in order to view that script. When we click OK, and close the Edit HTML dialog, we can examine the results of the edited HTML and JavaScript on this text area. HTML editing has caused the background color for each section title to turn light gray, making it easier to distinguish between each of the steps of this analysis workflow. JavaScript was applied in order to allow each section to be collapsed and expanded independently, making more efficient use of the space available for this text area on the page.